This video has a numerical problem based on evaluation of integrals. It says evaluate the integral of sin x upon sin x minus a with respect to x. Now see, in the denominator what do we have? X minus a. In the numerator we have only x. I have already told you about manipulation, that we need to manipulate the numerator according to the denominator. So how can we do it without affecting the question too? Let's see. I write solution and the question is sin x in the numerator while sin x minus a in the denominator. Now, if I want x minus a in the numerator, I can by subtracting a. But then the effect also has to be cancelled up by adding a. So I add a also. So the question doesn't change in short. Now, if I consider x minus a as one term and a as the other term such that x minus a is my capital A, small a is my capital B, then do you see a formula can be applied? Sin a plus b. What is sin a plus b? It is sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. And whole upon does not change. It is nothing but sin x minus a and everything with respect to x. So that is the further part of the question and solution now. Now what I have is the first term is nothing but integration sin x minus a cos a upon sin x minus a, which is nothing but cos a dx. Then is plus again integration, because we are separating the integral, sin a, already sin a, okay. So let me write it sin a here only. Cos x minus a upon sin x minus a is cot x minus a and dx already there. Now what is the last thing that we are going to consider? Cos a as a constant outside. Integration of 1 dx is nothing but x plus sin a constant outside. Integration of cot x minus a. What is integration of cot x minus a? It is log sin the angle x minus a and plus c, whatever is the constant of integration. So this is how you do this type of a question.